for everybody to be here. My name is I'm a road pedestrian in Asia. I'm gonna, this is my last year. And as Ali said, I also like to do this presentation. So I hope you're gonna enjoy it. So, my country is called Rwanda. This is the neighbor country. Only when you see in the north, it is Uganda, and south is Burundi, and east is Tanzania. This is the map. As you see, it's a really small country. It's like a dot on the African map. In the middle is the country from the map. Also, this is another one. My hometown is from Victoria. This is the capital. But most of the people are not from my country, they say Chambu. That's India. This is our flag. Here is the definition of the color. This flag was made after genocide, because we had a genocide in 1994. So after that, they changed the color of the flag. So this is a new flag. Population. This is the most populated country in Africa. Mm-hmm. The reason why is because two-thirds of the country is mountains and water. So most of people live on one-third of the land. And right now, it's almost 10 million of population. Mm-hmm. So that's why. Mm-hmm. And life expectancy is 47, mm-hmm. which is really low. But that's just okay. On religion, most of the population is Catholic. At 26 is a Protestant, Muslim is 4.6, and there's also a number of people who don't have a religion. The language will be French spoken because we're cornered by Belgium. But as I said, like after the war we had in 1994, the new regiment took a power and their English spoken. So 1 year ago they changed everything. They said we're not gonna teach French anymore in the high school or middle school. Now we're gonna use English. Mm-hmm. So it's a new thing in the country. Most of people they live under agriculture, and it's like 92%. And the climate, we have two big season climates. We don't have snow, it doesn't even get really hot like here. We don't have humidity. So we have a long one, it's like winter, but we don't have snow. That's the only difference. But during that weather, it's a long rain, very long rain.
And how cold? What is the temperature during that time?
The temperature we use Celsius is like 10 or 9, something like that. But I don't know in Fahrenheit. Yeah, we also have a lot long summer. It's hard, but it doesn't get humid. So the government is the democratic. The president has to be elected for 7 years. And you have a senator, deputy, court. History is a country. As I said, we used to have a king before the colonization, and after the colonization, we set up like a president, and our country got independence in July 1st, 1962. We have in a country, we have a 3 ethnic groups, but now we don't use ethnic anymore. It's just history. Before, we had a 3 ethnic groups, Kutu, Tutsi, and Twa. And then, but that's what they say, like, that's what I learned in history back home. They say, like, when people who colonized the country came, they couldn't find a way to divide the people around. And then they invented this kind of ethnic, so to make people have to fight each other. So that's how they invented it, like, Hutu to Tutsi. So among those two, Hutu and Tutsi, they start to fight each other, killing each other. So that's when, in 1969, Hutu ethnic killed like a Tutsi, and then some of the Tutsi escaped, and then they went to Uganda. When they, once they got there, they formed the army, so they want to come back in the country. But when they tried to come back in the country in a peaceful way, the president at that time didn't want it. So what happened? They said to fight. When they were fighting, they said, okay. When they started to fight, the people who were in the government, who were in the power that time, they said to say, okay, we have the people who are helping those guerrillas out of country. So they started to kill the Tutsi inside. So that's when the genocide started. But meanwhile, the president who was in power that time started to agree to sign the peace agreement. And then they killed him. So the genocide started. During that genocide time, it was like 1994. It lasted like 3 months, but almost 1 million of people were killed. And the way the genocide was stopped, the guerrilla who were fighting to get in the country, they gain power, because when you're killing people, no one is going to support you. So that's when they got forced. They took the power, and then they stopped the genocide. And people who did genocide, they flew to Congo, because they couldn't stay in the country. They were afraid that they're going to get in a jail. So they flew to Congo. Others went in Congo. As a consequence of genocide, many people between families and the other source of economy in this day is tourism. It's getting really, really high because of gorillas. They say there's one kind of gorilla called a silverback. They say it's probably one. They say Rwanda, this area, that's where you can find the only many kind of that of gorilla silverback. So if you want to see gorilla silverback, you only have to go in Rwanda to see it. So that's why it's getting really popular. About tourism, you have three different parks. One is called the Volcano Park. It's the Volcano Park. If you want to go see gorillas, you're going to go to Volcano Park. That's where you're going to go.